you'll need your integration to part 2 pack on page 7. Today I'm going to explain to you how to find what's called the mean value of a function. So obviously you'll know that to work out the mean of some numbers, you just add them up and divide by how many there are. The mean value of a function is kind of does something equivalent. It's worth thinking about how you'd work out the mean speed of an object moving. The mean speed, or the average speed, is got by doing the total distance travelled, which is the same as the area underneath the velocity time graph, and then divide by the time taken. We'll do something similar to work out the mean value of a function. The idea is explained and illustrated by this graph. So let's imagine we have this function here, y equals f of x, defined for x values between a and b. So it has this graph here. The mean value of the function is the constant value such that the area underneath the graph of that constant value between x is a and x is b is equal to the actual area under the curve. So the area under the curve, which I'll do green, is the integral from a to b of f of x dx. The area under a line whose height is y bar, that constant line there, is a rectangle. So its area is its height, which is y bar, times by its base. And if it goes from x is a up to x is b, the base is b minus a. So this gives you that the mean value of a function, which can be written as y bar, is simply got by integrating the function between the limits and then times it by 1 over the width of the interval. That is it. It's basically an integration question. So guys, I'm going to give a couple of examples of this. The first one's very straightforward, and then the second one's a bit more demanding. Find the mean value of f of x is x squared between x is 1 and x is 4. So all we need to do to find its mean value is integrate the function, which is x squared, from x is 1 to x is 4, and then times by 1 over the width of the interval. The interval goes from 1 to 4, so its width is got by doing 4 minus 1. So that's obviously a third. If you integrate x squared, you will get a third x cubed between 4 and 1. So that's a third into. If you sub in 4, you're going to get 4 cubed, a third times 4 cubed, which is a third times 64, sorry, a third times 64, or 64 over 3. Take away a third times 1 cubed, which is a third times 1, which is a third. So that's the same as a third times, well, 64 thirds, take away 1 third, is 63 thirds, which is 21, which means the mean value of that function is 7. I.e. the area under the graph of y equals x squared is the same as the area under the horizontal line y equals 7 if you measure areas between 1 and 4. And that's all that's involved. Now, conceivably, you might be asked to state mean values for formations of this function. The idea is these, I will illustrate by the following. So, if f of x is x squared plus 4, if you add on 4 to all of your values, then the average value goes up by 4. So the mean will be 7 plus 4, which is 11. In example 2, if I have f of x is 3x squared, if you multiply all the x values by 3, then the mean value will be multiplied by 3. It's 3 by 7, which is 21. In example 3, if you make all the y values negative, then their average will turn negative, so the mean value is minus 7. So these principles illustrated here. The mean of a function, if you add on k, the mean goes up by k. If you multiply by k, the mean is multiplied by k. If you stick a minus sign in front, the mean is minus y bar. Now I'm just going to go through one more example, which is perhaps more illustrative of something you could be asked to do. Find the exact mean value of f of x is x shine 2x from x is 0 to x is ln 2. Find the exact value. So the mean of this function is going to be got by doing the following. So it's 1 over the width of the interval, which is going to be ln 2 take away 0. times the integral of this function, which is the integral from 0 to ln 2 of x sine 2x dx. So the main part about this is how to integrate that function, and this is where any of the methods of integration we've done in the course, in either A-level maths or further maths, could be required. This function is two things multiplied together of a different type, so you want to use integration by parts. To integrate x sine 2x, you would do parts with u as x. To integrate x sine 2x, you'll do parts where u is x and dv by dx is sine 2x. If you differentiate that, you'll get du by dx is 1. If you integrate sine 2x, you will get a half cosh 2x. So this is going to give me 1 over ln 2 minus 0 is just 1 over ln 2 into, I'm not going to write the limit sheet, I'll do it at the end. So u times v is x times a half cosh 2x, a half x cosh 2x, minus the integral of v times du by dx, which is a half cosh 2x times 1, which is a half cosh 2x dx. You can then integrate that, so 1 over ln 2 into, so I'm going to put square brackets now, so a half cosh 2x is already integrated, minus, if you integrate, so a half x cosh 2x is already integrated, half cosh 2x will integrate to give a half times a half, which is a quarter sine 2x between ln 2 and 0. So that's going to give me 1 over ln 2 into, when you stick in ln 2 into this function, you're going to get a half ln 2 times the cosh of 2 ln 2 minus a quarter, sorry, times the sine of 2 ln 2. That's what you get if you stick in ln 2 in. Take away, if you stick in 0, then the first factor you've got a factor of 0, so that's 0. And the second factor you're going to have sine of 0, so that's 0, if you just take away 0. Now to finish this off, I'm going to simplify it a little bit on my calculator, because I think your calculator will simplify cosh of 2 ln 2 and sine of 2 ln 2 nicely for you. So your calculator, if you press option F6, F2, and then cosh, first of all, of 2 ln 2. It'll give you 2.125, as a fraction, 17 over 8. So this is going to give me 1 over ln 2 into a half times ln 2 times cosh of 2 ln 2, which is 17 over 8. Take away sine of 2 ln 2. 15 over 8. So take away a quarter times 15 over 8. Now my final answer is not going to be very nice. What I can do is, inside of the bracket, I can write it as a fraction with a common denominator of, well, my first term's going to have 16 on the bottom, second term's have 32 on the bottom. So I can write it as 1 over ln 2 times, putting it all over 32, you would get 34 ln 2 minus 15. So in its neatest possible form, 34 ln 2 minus 15 divided by 32 ln 2 is the exact value of that function between those points. And that's it. There's an exercise still on the next page for practicing this stuff. Please check you're okay with that. It's largely just practice using methods of integration. Okay, folks, that'll do. Thank you.